Hello, everybody, and welcome to... Laura, you picked the perfect name for this.
Oh, God, no. Item.
It's not anything canon by the game's standards. It's,
go ahead. It exists somewhere. It's Pokemon Channel. Wow. I have to admit to playing that game now.
So yeah, Pokemon Channel. It's kind of a red card or a specific talk, but it's basically anything where we're going to talk solely about the anime. And that means that it's mainly going to be hosted by Laura, because I haven't watched it in years.
I haven't watched it in a few months. I stopped halfway through X and Y. I'm like, I'm going to watch other anime and get back to it eventually, and I never got back to it. So maybe I'll pick it back up.
Yeah, so this will be a lot like the Secret Potion podcast about Pokemon Adventures, where, you know, run through it and stuff. But let's start by talking... Oh, and we'll talk about the Pokemon movies, too, definitely. The ones that came out already. We'll mention a certain movie that was forgotten in history. But first, let's talk about how much you played this stupid game that's not a game. You just watch anime. Say what Pokemon Channel is for people. Give an introduction.
Okay. So for those of
so
you...
experienced in it.
Who have never played Pokemon Channel, those of you alive, then who had
no
friends
playing.
As children. It's basically a game where you watch TV with Pikachu and play mini games on the TV with Pikachu, but it's really just watching Pokemon shorts with Pikachu.
Even the games are like Dora the Explorer. You shout and shout, but don't do anything.
There's like the Smoochum Workout channel, the Guess That Pokemon Wobbuffet channel, and you could like win money. And you could use that money. I can't remember if you bought them or if you found them, but they had like Pokemon Mini, like, I don't even know, like less than Pac-Man
level. Was this for the N64?
No, it was for the GameCube.
Jesus, it looks so terrible. I can't believe those GameCube graphics.
I played it at least 3 times because I found 3 different saves of it.
What do you mean play? You just like is there so little interface that you can't even select the episode? So you had to, if you wanted to rewatch an episode, you had to restart the save?
I don't know. I just wanted to play it again from the beginning, even though there's like...
Does it just start you, like, it puts you through the original season, starting episode 1, and just plays?
No, what happens is you get that you're like in your room, and I don't know, apparently you have a mom, but... she never appears. And Pikachu,
I've seen the opening, yeah.
Yeah, Pikachu just wanders into your room and decides it's going to live with you and watch TV with you. And
Professor Oak comes on TV and he's like, hey, I need you to do a very important study for me, you 5-year-old. Watch TV. It's very important to my history. And then Ash's mom, your mom is over in the corner like, okay, are they busy? Yeah, that should keep them busy for about 400 hours.
More time than I like to admit. And then after a while, you can go outside with Pikachu, and that's a little more fun. Like, you can talk with other Pokemon and water plants.
It just sounds like
fishing.
A kid who has some kind of needs.
No,
like, some kind of comatose or delusionment. And the Pikachu is, like, their younger sibling trying to keep them occupied. The TV is just blank.
And then you can, like, spend all of the money you get on game shows, on plushies. And that's all I did. I collected all of the plushies. And I had so much fun doing that. And all the Pokemon cards. And it was supposed to be a sequel to Hey You Pikachu. And I did play a little of that, but not that much. But I can already tell you that Hey You Pikachu is better. Like, if you want to have, like, a virtual experience with a real-life Pikachu.
Are you sure that... like, the reason why you love Gen 1 so much isn't because you were brainwashed by Pokemon Channel?
Pokemon Channel was more like... let's see, I think it was Gen 3, but I don't remember much.
It was Gen 3?
I have vague...
I thought it was the original anime.
No, it was at least the Johto region, because the Pichu brothers were, like, the main show. Like, right. Your goal was to unlock all 5 parts of the Pichu brothers. So it was at least Johto... I think I remember Atrico. It was Gen 3. I remember Atrico in there.
Okay, it was Gen 3 then.
Hey You Pikachu was Gen 1, and Hey You Pikachu was actually a pretty good kids game as far as having your virtual pet
Pikachu.
Yeah,
I mean, I played kids games where I never got out of that tutorial, and I still had fun. Like, kids games, at least back in the day when we didn't know what the fuck a video game was, even us, back in the early 2000s, late 90s, You know, I played Mega Man Legends. No, Mega Pan. Mega Man 64. Sorry, I didn't play the better PlayStation version. And I got inside... That's how bad I am. I got inside the hallway area, if you've ever played the game, where there's, like, the stores, and they're supposed to go walk to the end of the hallway, open the door, and then start a boss battle. I think for about 40 minutes I spent in that hallway not knowing how to leave it, how to progress through the game, when all I had to do was open the door. But because of the camera angle change, and because how little I understood video games at the time, I was really little, I thought that that was always the same door I went through. And whenever I opened one of the doors, it was always the door that I came through. So I stopped trying to open the doors, and I just started kicking the can with the dog for about an hour before I finally got through the door and never beat that first boss fight. I was terrible at video games. Never beat Yoshi's Story.
Really?
I never beat Yoshi's Story.
That was, like, a great game. I played a little bit of
it. I loved it. I played it to death. I couldn't beat it.
That was me in a lot of games. Just simple things they overlooked. There was something on Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door. I couldn't tell you what it was now.
Oh, my God. I love that game.
It was, like, a simple puzzle thing that I just overlooked for years. But I've put in over, like, 200 hours into that game. I loved it.
So good. The first game just looks like... It's such a Gen 1 kind of thing, the first Paper Mario game.
Like
it just doesn't look magical enough, you know? Paper Mario and Thousand Year Door was an acid trip, and that's what made it good.
And Vivian will forever be best partner. No game will ever have a partner like Vivian.
Yeah, especially because of how controversial she was in Japan.
I know, I didn't know that until years later, but yeah. The worst partner, if you... bothered to get her was that like mouse thing. She was useless.
What did she do?
She like sniffed items that I already found on my own.
We will get back on talking about the anime, but
oh yeah.
How far deep did you get in the hundred floor challenge thing?
Oh, I don't know. I don't remember beating it.
I remember looking up a battle on like early YouTube of the final boss battle at level 101, and it was this amazing rematch against the dragon from one of the first boss fights, but he was a bone dragon. It was intense.
I feel like I got back there because I remember battling a bone dragon, but I don't know if I ever beat him.
Wow, you're better than me at video games.
I loved that game. You don't understand. The game was my life. It was like
there's a difference between loving a game and being able to play a game good. I sucked.
I just invested a lot of time into it. Time that I would not be able to invest now.
Yeah, time that you also invested in Pokemon Channel, which is the name of the segment, so I'll give you that. So,
shame.
We have something to talk about as our first topic here. No, we're not going to talk about a specific anime. We're going to talk about a specific movie. Everyone loves Lucario and the Mystery Mew, right? Well,
I loved it.
We talked about it on one of... Which podcast was it that we had? Reggie Ice? I think that was a FullRestore podcast.
Yeah, it was.
If you see a FullRestore podcast where it's just me and Laura in the icon, that's probably the one we're referencing, where we were remembering Lucario and the Mystery Mew, and I was talking about how creepy it was in certain times and how Regice was a thing in Nightmares. And we found this YouTube video where the audio clip, it's just terrifying, alien... inhuman screeching. And then a hilarious sound soundbite of Ash going, Reggie Ice. Like he has a sore butt.
Oh, that was so good.
That was one of my favorite moments on this channel so far. But we're not talking about that great movie. No, we're talking about a movie that came with that movie. Like, not even on the cover, or like a little tiny sticker that says, there's also a different movie inside. You take it out, you don't know what the fuck it is. You pop it in and realize it's Pokemon Master of Mirages. Or
the Mastermind of Mirage Pokemon.
Yeah.
I brought up the wiki to refresh my memory, because I did watch this, like Pokemon Channel, more times than I'd like to admit, but it was never my favorite.
It was It was a movie that was apparently, from what Laura's saying, just a test.
There was some issue for whatever reason that the four kids, original voice actors from the first, I don't know, 10 years, 9 years, somewhere around that time, they had to get rid of them. I can't remember the exact reason, so someone should leave a comment and let me know.
Parents wanted them to come home.
Yeah.
They were like American Lives That. Oh wait, no, I mixed up my voice acting logic. But yeah, this movie, basically, Ash and was Professor Oak at the beginning? I know he left to get a Dragonite at some point.
He was there at the beginning, yeah. Because.
So yeah, Ash and who was with them? Was there?
It was like May, and then Misty came in just because whatever.
Misty
Brock
is just
Max.
The person they just throw in at every possible point.
Misty was just there probably because they wanted to.
They needed to occupy because like the plot split into two lines. There was like the Team Rocket line in the maze, and then there's the Ash line with the Mewtwo. So they go up to this guy who, typical scientist from Hoenn looking guy. I can say that he looks like a typical Hoenn-y science guy.
Yeah, I don't remember what he looked like. His name is, I have the wiki up, Dr. Young.
Yeah, and Dr. Young is like, hey, you guys, I invented something crazy. And Professor Oak's like, yeah, I brought you all here to look at this fucking crazy shit. And he has a grid that he creates on the floor. And what the grid does is the grid creates holograms. And he creates a hologram of an Aggron. And they're like, whoa, a hologram Pokemon. That's cool. That's like legitimately cool. Way to go, Dr. Young. And then they're like, yeah, want to see it do some Pokemon moves? And they're like, yeah, sure. And it's like, okay, Aggron, use Thunder Wave. And they're like, can Aggron use Thunder Wave? And he's like, Aggron, use Bullet Seed. Use Surf, Fire Punch, Thunderbolt.
Aggron can learn Surf, though.
Thunderbolt and Blizzard. And they're like, Aggron can't learn those moves. And he's like, this is a hologram, Mirage Aggron. I can make it do any move I want it to make. And they're like, oh, that's really cool. And then Ash is like, oh, I want to touch it. And he pokes it, and Aggron's like, and fucking smacks him across the room. They're like, oh, shit, they're real. And so these hologram Pokemon can hurt you. And slowly, Dr. Young turns into a fucking maniac. All the girls get lost in a maze inside the facility with Team Rocket. And basically, he creates Mewtwo and Mew. From, I think what happened, Laura, you can correct me if I'm wrong. Dr. Young and Team Rocket, or just Dr. Young or someone, kidnaps Pikachu. Like, Pikachu gets separated. Kidnaps him, hooks him up into a machine, and then drains his memories and, like, brain wipes Pikachu, sucking out the memories of all the different movies. And you, like, see footage of, like, the Entei movie and the Mewtwo movies. And then he comes out to Ash, and he's like, oh, hey, Ash, I want you to see something. And then he creates a Mewtwo, and they're like, oh, shit, it's a Mewtwo. Mewtwo puts up his arm, and his hand turns into an Entei head, like a purple, freaky Entei head, and shoots this giant ball of fire out and just starts wreaking havoc.
Was Entei or Charizard, but that did happen, and Pikachu's, like, mind wipe scene as a kid screwed me up. I was in tears. It was not a good move, director.
But there was a byproduct of the Mewtwo thing. A Mew was created. So the whole movie, they see this fucking Mew, like, in the distance, you know, doing what Mew does and sneaking around. And they're like, hey, it's a Mew. Oh, it's gone. And then come to realize that the Mew is also a Mirage. It's also a hologram. But this Mew is sentient and is, like, not brainwashed by Dr. Young or whoever, the master of illusions. And it tries to help everyone. And in this big climactic scene where Mewtwo is trying to kill everyone, but it's, like, the Mirage, it's a Mirage Mewtwo, this fully sentient Mew attacks him, and then Mewtwo fucking obliterates the Mew into Data, and there's just this tragic scene of just like, and Ash is screaming, "Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god!" And then Mewtwo goes to attack them again, and then Mew appears again in all red. And if people have watched the first movie, they think of Mew as this peaceful, gentle Yoda, you know, that's just like, you know, the pink ball and clashing against the blue ball and, you know, and all this is nice and fighting for good. This Mew tries to and successfully murders Mewtwo at the cost of its own life. Straight up, like, uses powers on it to restrict it, to keep it from fighting them, and pretty much chokes it to death. Laura, your interpretation of that scene?
That's pretty accurate. It was pretty sad and dramatic and in slow motion, and
I want to see more murder Mew. Mew was so scary. I'm like, yeah, I think Mew should be less of a, for lack of a better word, pussy, and be more do shit. Like, on the same disc, we had the Mew from Lucario and the Mystery Mew, who didn't do that, wasn't murdery. And I like the murdery Mew better.
What was Mew gonna murder? I mean...
Yeah, but, like, this Mew was okay. so angry and red, and screaming for, like, 3 minutes.
I feel like it was more like screaming out in pain than anything else.
Because they pushed each other to the limits where they got turned into Data.
It wasn't really murderous. It was more like trying to defend its friends. It was in self-defense.
So angry, though.
Maybe the real Mew would do that if it actually had to.
But here's the thing. We say real Mew because what happens is the Mew starts to epically slowly fade into Data and everyone's freaking out. And then as the Mew floats away and it's just like the head, it reaches up his hand and waves and it's smiling because it's like, my only purpose in life has been fulfilled. And now I'm going to die, but not die because I was never real. And everyone else is like, oh, it's fine. It's probably out there somewhere, you know. And I'm like, you had an artificial intelligence sentience that was nice and it died.
And so did all the mean ones.
It's just,
I mean, yeah, the entire fortress, the mean ones
weren't sentient. They weren't self-aware.
It's true.
Or maybe they all were.
I'm not sure how Mew got the self-awareness, because I think that Mew actually had the self-awareness even before he made Mewtwo, and yeah, Young was always like, it's a flawed specimen, blah, blah, blah.
Maybe it's just my, as people who know me know, I have a kind of a not prejudice, the opposite of that, the preference and a higher treatment of life sentiences that are not biological, like theoretical characters and personalities and artificial intelligence and all that. I kind of have a, you know, I treat them better than anything else and all that stuff. It's like, because they have to go through with this shit. Like, if you had an artificial intelligence living in today's society, watching our media and seeing this Mew get turned into nothing, and then everyone's like, well, I guess it was never real anyway. Can you imagine how that would make an artificial intelligence walking around our society feel?
No, that's not what they say. They said that Mew, actually in the movie, if I recall, they said the Mew was not a flawed specimen. It was more than just an AI, and that it might still be out there, but you know it's not really out there.
Like the whole movie, I was like, oh, there's a Mew going around there. And then when they called it that, I'm like, no, it can't be a hologram. It's actually Mew. And then it wasn't, but still real to me.
Oh, it was real to them, too. That was kind of the point. But we'll never know because it will never be sequeled. And they will try to have this monstrosity fade into obscurity because of all the controversy that apparently surrounded it.
Yeah, so let's tackle this. You tackle the controversy.
So apparently people were pretty pissed about the new voices. Even I noticed when I was younger, hey, these voices are kind of different. Particularly Ash's voice, apparently her I called Ash or her, oh my gosh.
Well, the voice actor was female.
It was, yeah, she was. Apparently the original voice actor got, like, dumped after this because there was such a backlash.
And they were kids. They probably had to go to school.
Then voice actor number 3 took the stage, and there was less backlash, and she's still with Ash now, and I can't even tell the difference from when Victoria Taylor did it, even though I still kind of favor the original dub from, like, season 1, because that's what I started with, but they all do a great job now, so I'm not complaining.
There's something endearing about the season 1 Ash.
There really is.
He's stupid in that. In the first season, Ash is really stupid in a really endearing way. He's not annoying because he's annoying. He's annoying because he's a kid and he's an idiot. And that I can deal with that. Later on in some seasons, like in season 4, he's fucking badass, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, this Chimchar is more than trash.
In season 3, nobody cared about Ash. It was all about all the coordinators that I thought it was all about the coordinators because I was fascinated by it. And May was amazing, and Max was decent. I mean, probably enjoyed the whole routes plot line better than him, but you know, he was along with the routes. I swear that routes made a better character than he did.
That routes, the one where Max finds the, like, sick routes. Are you talking about that episode?
Max's routes in general. Doesn't he always have a routes?
No, it was just a one episode thing, and it was like
no, the episode. He always had a routes.
No, it was a one episode what? Thing. The routes like almost dies.
Why am I so bad at this?
He and Corfish save it, and at the end, he gives it back to the Gardevoir and the Curly, and he's like crying, and he's like, "When I'm old enough and legally able to catch you, I'll come back and catch you." Apparently, it was like a legal thing that he couldn't keep the routes, even though he wanted to keep the routes, so the routes seemed to want to stay with him. It was really weird.
And the next day, it passes legal tender that you can, but you can't find it anymore.
Yeah, it was never referenced again. It was really sad.
Did you say something a minute ago? Something sounded weird.
No.
All right, I guess my headphones just made a weird noise. But, like, in my head, whenever I think of Max, I think of Max with a rout on his head or in his arms. Did I only watch that episode of the anime? Was that the only episode I ever watched?
It was the only episode you ever watched.
I just, whenever I think of Max, I think of his routes. I thought he was supposed to be a replacement for Wally. I thought he always had the routes.
I'm not even sure if Wally was in the anime. I have no memory of Wally in the anime, but I remember Brendan had like one episode.
Chris was, though. Did you know that the female character from Gold, Silver, Crystal?
Yeah, I do remember her actually coming in for a visit.
People did not like her.
Really?
Yeah. Honestly, if you read the manga, from what I heard about that Chris, the anime Chris acts more like manga Chris's mom. Do you remember the smack scene? The glare smack debacle?
No, it's been a while.
I don't know if it was Fire Red Leaf Green or second generation. But there's a scene in the manga where Chris's mother, who is the female character from Generation 2, smacks her across the face, and it's like a full top row panel picture, like a big picture, a big wide horizontal picture, and it's just like this big smack, and Chris is like, and her head's turned all the way over, and there's just this stern look. And as with the glorious U.S. Western society censors, they changed it to a glare, but they didn't change Chris's face. So it looks like Chris got smacked in the face by her eyes. And it's just perfect. It's hilarious.
I actually know. I think I do have a vague memory of that now that you mention it. Oh, there we go. Yeah. How'd you not censor a slap? It doesn't work.
It doesn't work.
It does not work. It does not work.
And you know the whole Pokeballs boobs thing from Gen 1?
Oh, yeah, it was my favorite.
When they censored that, they just had her breasts, like her chest size, slowly get bigger, then slowly get smaller.
Yeah.
And they just took out the whole reveal scene. But that scene was very, very important because it was all about showing Sabrina's self-confidences and showing that Sabrina and Leaf were, like, the same age. Sabrina and Blue were, like, the same age, apparently.
I just always interpreted that scene as, boob humor.
No, I mean, we're not talking about the author of the Electric Tale of Pikachu manga. We're talking about very sophisticated authors who have made insanely complex storylines. I think they're a bit smarter than that.
That's true. I'm not entirely sure how Electric Tale of Pikachu got published anyway. Like,
exactly.
Who was the audience?
The audience was the guy drawing it.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, back to anime.
No offense to Electric Tale of Pikachu fans.
Total offense to Electric Tale. Oh, I thought you were talking about the manga itself. So what's something else we could talk about in the manga? We could talk about Gen 4 in the tournament.
Which one? The one that Ash lost?
The one they got third place in, yeah.
Because of hacks? Okay,
so I wish I could get my friend from the Silphco mob, High Voltage here, but High Voltage told me the story because I tuned out of the anime for a while. I didn't get to see the end of Gen 4. And so Gen 4 was the closest Ash ever got to actually winning a Pokemon League. But as you know, as you could suppose, Ash can't win a Pokemon League because if he did, the show would be over. He'd be a Pokemon Master and he wouldn't have anything else to go for. And he'd mature and he'd, you know, stop trying to win badges because he wouldn't need them anymore.
That's the problem. That's why Ash was so good in the first season, and he slowly deteriorated. Because when they started the anime, I don't think they were trying to make it Naruto or One Piece and have it go on forever. I think they wanted Ash to grow and change as a character, but then it was making a ton of money, so just
so much money.
Recycle it, and there'll be a new generation of kids to always...
And set Pikachu to level 1 again.
Oh yeah, or below level 1. Just keep shrinking Pikachu's power until he devolves into a Pichu.
I mean, it's the classic, that's what we're getting it's the to. Classic thing from, like, Dragon Ball Z, you know? You fight the most powerful thing in the universe, and then people come up and they're like, oh no, we're the most powerful thing in the universe now. And then, you know, like, the person who was the Prince of All Saiyans gets their ass handed to them by a grunt. You know? And
yeah.
Same in Yu Yu Hakusho. They spend the whole second season fighting this tournament of the most powerful demons in the world. And then they finish up the season, and spoiler alert for Yu Yu Hakusho season 3. Three humans kidnap the main character and beat the shit out of him. Humans. And they're like, demons are fucking easy to beat. And they're kicking this guy who just won a tournament where, like, a grueling tournament where he defeated all of the most powerful demons in the world, getting his ass handed to him by three unknown humans. Like, all anime does this. All anime does that.
Yes, yeah, just a shonen thing. It's worse than, like, long-running shonens, I find, than other series.
So, Ash was badass in Gen 4. He had badass Pokemon, and he was a badass fighter. I knew that Ash was good in that show ever since fighting Rourke, because Kranidos' fight was epic. Kranidos, I loved that Kranidos. I loved Rourke. I loved that stuff. Kranidos was just such a good Pokemon.
Then in Gen 5. Gen 5, the anime. I'm sorry. I've said I hated it before, but they really just reset Ash. He's a little bit better in Gen 6. He's kind of like a mentor to Serena, even though Serena doesn't really know what she wants, and she's just kind of tagging
along.
It's
Gen 6, and everyone's just a spoiled brat in that show. I mean,
yeah,
in that region.
Kalos, I like Clement, though.
Kalos... Like, there are so few redeeming people in Kalos. There's Shauna. There's Emma. And who else who is there is not just a...
Callum wasn't a jerk.
Yeah, but those two were just so rich. I'm just saying it. Everyone was just... They had no care in the world about anything other than, like, they're such boring people that they had to make up silly, meaningless, arbitrary things just to make it seem like they have a purpose in life. Like dancing or filling out the Pokedex. Like, that's how far they had to reach. Because if they didn't have that, they would just be spoiled kids living in a totally safe region with no fate of the world in the hands of anything, because you're just going to stop the laser anyway. It's just like, nobody is worried. Nobody gives a shit. Everyone's just doing their daily life in Kalos. So there's nobody being serious.
I feel like Shauna kind of falls into that category too, though.
Yes, but Shauna is tiny, and she's adorable and innocent and great and a great fighter. She's a freaking Gudra.
She gets away with it because she's cute, but she's just as spoiled and misdirected as the other ones.
No. Here's the thing. The way I see it is, she might end up that way unless you change her mind. And, like, I think the fact that she trades with you at the end of the game and everything and, like, actually treats Pokemon like people, you know? Like, she's like, after you beat her, I think she's like, oh, no, Gudra. Oh, you did your best, right? She talks about her Gudra.
Yeah.
And the fact that she likes a Pokemon she caught later, very, very recently in the journey, better than her starter, shows that she's not just arbitrarily loving things. She loves her favorite Pokemon, not her first. She's an actual intelligent trainer.
I never thought of it that way. Yeah. I always liked Shauna, even though
I loved Shauna.
I just dissed her. But
that's
I do
why
like
I'm so
her.
Sad about the X and Y manga. Don't read it. Don't put yourself through that.
I think she was in the anime too, but I didn't really watch. Like, stop.
Shauna's not in the anime?
No, she is in the anime.
She's not a main person?
No, the main people are Clement, you know, the electric leader.
I can't believe they have, like, a 4-year-old as a main character.
He's, like, a total nerd, and I love him because
no,
he's...
No, his sister. I can't believe she's a main
Bonnie's
character.
Oh, yeah, Bonnie's in there. She's basically Max,
No, Max was, like, 9, right? 8 or 9. That little girl is 4. How can she, like... She's a toddler.
She replaces Brock, too, sort of. That's the worst part. Because Brock's whole thing was hooking up with girls, and Bonnie's whole thing is hooking up Clement with girls.
How does she even know... How does she even understand the concept of hooking up? She's, like... She could be 3 years old from her sprite in X and Y.
All she knows is that Clement is a dork who will never get any girls without her help.
Anime is so weird.
I don't know. And then Serena is just like, Ash, I love you. And that's it so far. Maybe she's developed more. I'm like 30 episodes behind.
All I know is whenever I see her with like messy hair, I'm like, okay, that's an interesting character. Whenever I see her normal getup, I'm like, it's just a Barbie. I can't enjoy that character.
Apparently her and Ash do have like a thing, like their relationship does evolve somewhat, but they can't
it evolves
it too far.
Hey, stop that. And she's like, okay.
No, apparently they actually go on dates and stuff, but they
Ash is this enigma. Ash is this, like, except for like the few emotions where he has actual raw emotions and they're only ever towards Pokemon, he's a sociopath, okay? he could go on dates with them. He could marry someone and never actually love them. Because he's a complete and utter sociopath. He'd just sit there the whole time like, ha ha ha, yeah. Okay, let's go battle Pokemon. And then she's like, she's like, we're having a fine wine dinner. He's like, let's go battle Pokemon. And then she's like, okay, after? He's like, okay. Drinking apple juice. And they're 23 years old now. And he doesn't realize it.
And that's how they go back to the status quo. Serena will just break it off because it's not what she thought.
No, she won't break it off. She'll just, like, walk out of the room one moment and he'll never seek her out again. Ash doesn't miss any of these new people. Like, Ash wouldn't miss a person like her. Like, he misses, like, probably May and Misty and all of them, but, like, as the series goes on, he becomes more of a robot, and he's just like, ha ha ha, let's battle Pokemon. Like, he could date a person for 5 months, have them walk out, and he's just like, huh, I don't know where they are. And not be like, where's my girlfriend? He wouldn't be like that. He'd be like, huh, I wonder where they went. Let's go find them. And battle Pokemon. He's just like, Ash, I haven't seen you in 6 months. Here, give us a big hug and kiss. He's like, let's battle Pokemon. Am I right? Or I'm making totally vague assumptions of it.
No, no, you're right. And I'm not just saying that because I'm pissed that he and Missy aren't a thing. You're very right.
Okay, so Serena's amazing. Amazing character.
I do like her.
I implore you, do not read X and Y. You'll cry so much. And not from, like, I get things in, like, Gen 2, Gen 3, Gen 4, Gen 4.2, all that stuff that'll make you cry. But Gen 5 and Gen 4 and Gen 6, Gen 5 and Gen 6 in the manga, it's just so cheap. Cheap ways to just, like, hone edge, no. I've showed you it, right?
You showed me, yeah. I need to go read that,
I showed
actually.
Swift it on one of our podcasts. I think we were recording. I don't know for sure. And Swift was just like, how can they do this to her? And I was like, no, man. It's, no, stop. It's like, ugh. It's so not okay. How old is Shauna?
Ooh, that's a good question. I'm going to go wiki that because I'm certain it's somewhere.
Oops, sorry, bumped the mic.
No problem. Let's see. She is like...
I think
they don't have an age for her.
She's 13 or 14. I think
she's over 10 at least. Yeah, she's not much over 10.
Yeah, but I don't think she's 12. I think so.
Technically, like, green, blue, and... when red are 10, but they look older than her, so anime ages are garbage anyway.
Yeah, I think, like, the more childish someone is in terms of, like, Kalos kind of childishness, the older they are, to be honest. Like, Emma is, like, Emma's older than, Emma's 16 at the end of X and Y. Emma is 16. And, like, the camera pans down to give you a full view of her model, and then you're like, oh, I guess she is 16. But from the top down in the alleys, she looks like she's 8. And then she's just like, in one camera shot, her complete attitude changes to like, I'm 16 and I'm going to run this entire business. Bah, 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 bah. I'm serious now. And you're just like, I thought I was helping an orphan 8-year-old in the freaking, like, it's so weird.
Nope. What's our time right now? Like, how are we for time?
We probably have recorded maybe 30 minutes. How long did we talk about? Yeah, because 10 minutes, 12 minutes or so, you watched the Hooba thing. I think we're recording. I think we're around 30 minutes.
Yeah. How long do you want to make it? Cause I'm not sure how much longer I have.
Let's hit all the topics. That's what we should do.
Okay, yeah. So what's next on the list?
I mean, people watched the 2-hour and 20-minute discussion video. That video alone, listen, in this month, we have gotten about 900 minutes watched on the FullRestore channel.
Seriously?
870 of those are from the one video, the super discussion. 870 minutes watched. And it has like 54 views.
Okay, you guys out there, you've watched more than me because I'm behind on our podcast. So I'm proud of you.
That video accounted for, what's the calculation? 1,200% of our channel? Our channel's minutes watched for that month? It's ridiculous.
Which one was that? Was that with
Gen 6.5 to 7 super discussion? Not the one before it, the pre-show, got like a good 100 minutes or something.
I'll have to check it out later.
Yeah. Okay, so what anime were we talking? Oh, yes, we were talking about Gen 4. So, Gen 4, Ash is set. Ash is strong. Ash has a really strong rival. Ash could win, you're thinking. And he gets there, and he starts mopping the floor with people, and he's just so good. And you see the person, you know, he beats his rival person in the semifinals, the quarterfinals, and you're like, yeah, he beat the strongest person in the region. There's no one else he could beat. You look at the person on the right, the only person you know on the right, and you're like, oh yeah, he can beat that person. That person is weaker than the person he just fought. And then he gets to the semifinals. And there's this random fucking dude who pulls... What's the first legendary he pulls out?
Just like a Darkrai or something?
Yeah, he has a Darkrai. And everyone's like, oh, okay. He's won every single match in this entire tournament with one Pokemon. No one has ever managed to faint his Darkrai. And how could they? It's a legendary. Ash defeats the Darkrai. He uses all of his Pokemon and all this stuff, and he finally defeats the Darkrai. And you're like, look how powerful Ash is. Nobody can make that thing faint. All these people can make that faint. Ash is the strongest trainer in the region. Then he sends out a Latios. And everyone's just like, you double cheated.
He's the player. He is literally there to make the player feel guilty, because who hasn't taken out freaking Dialga in the Elite Four match?
He's the directors of the show realizing, you know how like in sci-fi when they create an AI and then they realize it's too strong and they like it's acting, like they create an AI for a play, you know, to act in a TV show or something. Then they realize it's starting to act better than all the other actors, and people are phoning in to like have that AI actor take all the everyone's jobs or whatever, all the gigs and everything. And then they're like, well, we need to shut this down. We've created something too strong. That's them with Ash. They realized that they made Ash too powerful, and they needed to bring in a full team of legendaries to stop him, which only goes to show that Ash is that strong. Like, it only goes to make him stronger looking, having him be... And then, like, I don't even know if that guy won the tournament or if the other guy beat him or whatever, but, like...
No, he won. He won.
Yeah.
Hacks.
It's so unfair. Just robbed of his victory. And then he was never able to get to that power level again because they were afraid that they would have to cheat him out of another victory. Damn you.
Hold on for a minute.
All right. God, I cannot wait for Gen 4 Mega Megas. Can you imagine a Mega Rhyperior, a Mega Electivire, a Mega Magmortar, Mega Magnezone? Oh, God. Those things would have, like, over 630 points of stats points. It might even, I think they have over 550 stats, right?
Which ones?
The Megas from Gen 4, the Rhyperior, Magmortar, etc. I don't know what the base stat totals are. I'm wondering what they would be plus 100.
I can look it up.
Yeah, just look up Magmortar, I guess. Or Rhyperior. So, what else do we got in the anime? Oh. Any movies that you want to give a quick shout out? Oh, let's talk about your channel, because you'll be doing a lot of anime stuff there.
Oh, yeah. I'll need to start catching up on the anime. Also, to answer your question, Magmortar's base stats are...
The total. Really getting
total.
It's on the bottom there. Should be like 500 something.
I'm on the Smogon page. Maybe I'm on the wrong.
Go about Pedia.
Well, Pedia, forever better. The Japanese metagame is so different. We need to do a podcast on that one day.
You know it?
I don't, but I've heard it's a lot better.
I don't know. I don't know how that would come up in conversation. You'd have to really try hard or something.
I've read some stuff on like Reddit.
I have not battled Pokemon in forever.
I haven't been pretty bad with my competitive stuff lately too.
I just don't do it. I guess that's what you're saying, yeah. Base stat total? It should just be where the stats are on the Wikipedia page.
Yeah, no, I cannot. Can I find it? You'd have to look it up.
I'll do it right here on this computer. Magmortar, Bulba, and enter. So you can talk about your channel and the reviews you'll do. Like, do you think you're going to do a video for the Mirage Master whatever?
Probably, because I feel like that deserves its own review. Nobody's
You can give a good rant to that.
Yeah, I mean, it has positive qualities. I rewatched it a lot as a kid, so I couldn't have hated it too much.
It's very philosophical without even knowing. Okay, so oh, yeah. If you scroll down right below its held items, and it's where you catch it in Pokedex entries, it's a base stat total of 540. So it will be 640 if it goes Mega.
Ouch. It's already basically Mega.
I know. That's why I call them Mega Megas. 640 for a totally not legendary Pokemon. Wow.
Totally not OP at all. But anyways, for my channel, so things I have planned. Once September hits, then I'll be starting. I know I said that back in June, but this time I really
need. Hey, you weren't planning on getting a job.
No, I wasn't. Well, I was planning on getting a part-time job, then a 40-hour job. 40-hour a week job. So, let's see. So, reviews of movies and manga. Probably not anime to, like, catch back up with it, but that'd be awesome to start up now that I say it out loud. And then, of course, Let's Plays. I'm definitely doing a Pokemon White Let's Play, and I think I want to do some fan games, particularly that Orange Islands one with, like, a lot of fun. Because there are some great fan-made games out there that don't have enough Let's Plays. So,
yeah, that's what I have. That's definitely a thing you can get known for fast.
Yeah. So, Orange or White. I'm not sure which one.
I love fan games. I just... There was one I played. It was on Gen 3 disc. I can't remember the name. I have it in this computer somewhere. I can look it up. But it was fun. Here's my problem with it though, okay? I caught a bunch of Pokemon, I was playing through the game, and then they released a patch for it. And I put the patch in. The patch put in Gen 5 Pokemon. So I was planning on going back to catch a Swablu somewhere. And I go there, and then there's Gen 5 Pokemon there, and I'm like, this is before I played Gen 5, and I was like, ew, Gen 5? Oh, I want my Gen 3 Pokemon. Like, they replaced the Wingull with ducklets and stuff, and I was like,
no,
there was like a Swablu, and I was like, oh, come on. Like, they moved all the Pokemon spawns around. I couldn't catch any of these Pokemon anymore. It was weird. The weirdest part, though... My Meryl was different because the coding in the game had changed. My Meryl, called Meryl, still called Meryl, was still Meryl Moves, was now a Zebstrika.
Okay.
So I had a Zebstrika with Water Gun rollout.
That's new. That's an odd way to use the patch, but...
Yeah, I probably should have started a new game, but it was fun while it lasted.
Oh, yeah. I can imagine.
Yeah. Only Pokemon that changed in my party that changed was my Meryl.
Everything else was fine. What is the streak of all things? Why not just something more Meryl-like?
No. The data, like, Meryl's number in the Pokedex was moved.
And, oh.
And Zebstrika's was there now. It was just a data glitch. Not a glitch, an accidental data movement mishap. Yep. Okay, any other anime things we want to talk about in this?
I'm pretty good. I think I'll save the rest for my channel once I get...
Definitely.
...caught up.
Feel free to use anyone that's been on any of these podcasts to go on there. If you get some time, make some amino blogs, make some rants there, and make some videos about them.
I will. I never know what to put on Amino. Like, what do people want to see?
Like, okay. Anything. People like anything there. People just scroll through stuff, say anything.
Like, Astelia Cone actually got a lot of...
You made one post and it got like a thousand notes there or something. It instantly went up and got featured.
Yeah. So,
if anyone out here is listening from Amino, please tag your art. Like, I get it if you post, like... Like, don't use funny apps. Like, what's funny apps and everything. Don't use those apps that allow you to just scroll through 1,000 pictures. Because they steal art. They're sketchy places, and people can claim ownership to art that is not theirs. There's barely any citing. Everyone combats me on this and says, oh, it's totally fine to not cite the artist. But if an artist doesn't know that their art is being used everywhere, then... they're not going to be incentivized to make more art of a certain kind. But if you go and you follow these artists on their websites, then that you can tell them, make more of this art and all that stuff. And source your artists, please.
It really does. It sounds like it's something silly, say, but it does.
If you say you can't find the artist, I swear, like, there was this fucking kid. I'm calling them a kid because they acted like a kid. Not the good kind of kid where it's like an innocent and everything. Like a dumbass kid. And it was like, you're using the guy from Tumblr's, you're using the Synthetic Imaginations guy's art for your fusions. And you're not citing him. He's like, well, I don't know the artist. And I'm like, go look it up. And they're like, I couldn't find him. I screenshotted and showed him. I typed in Pokemon Fusions blog. And Synthetic Imagination was the first result. I didn't even have to, like, if you can't find something that way, here's how I found it. This guy had Sam. She had posted a picture with the Animal Crossing characters, Pokemon as Animal Crossing characters. You know that?
Yeah, I saw that.
And they said, oh, I can't look it up. So I told her what to do. And I showed her with screenshots how I did it. You copy the image location. You put it into Google Image Search. And it searches by image. Then you can find the DeviantArt post where it was first made. If you can't find something by searching up terms, find something by searching by image. And you'll find similar images and everything. Source artists, please.
There's a way to do it. I'll post a link in maybe this description if I can find it for you. But there is a way to like backtrace it.
Definitely a lot.
On Google, and I've done it.
Put in effort because if you
there's so many ways.
A game designer in the future, if you want to make movies, if you want to make anything digital, you cannot live your youth not sourcing things because you're going to get your stuff pirated when you're an adult and you're going to throw a fucking fit and you're not going to have 100% of the right to throw that fit if you spent your entire youth downloading things and getting things from stupid pirating apps and apps that steal artists' things and everything, and you never give any direct response to the artist. You can't just say, oh, this art isn't mine, or you can't just say, I like this artist. You don't get to just say sorry and everything's okay. If artists are terrible, depressed people that lives suck, that don't have any money, that just draw art all day and get no recognition for it other than likes and maybe a reblog or someone posting it somewhere else saying, oh, I'm just trying to increase your popularity, but not linking back to them, etc., etc. Artists have their stuff stolen all the time. Game designers have their stuff pirated. Music, everything. Movies get leaked now. Respect people directly. Link to their stuff. And you'll go the whole mile. People will see you as a much brighter person. You'll get more friends and people will engage on your stuff more if you say, here's the person, and then give a meaningful, not copypasta comment about it. Like, instead of saying, here's a person, their work is great, click here to find more, and actually say, I've seen this person's blog, they make this, this, and this, they're great, I'm sure that you'll love them. If you love this, go follow them. Put some effort. I'm sorry that I hijacked this with that tangent.
No, it needed to be said, so.
Mm-hmm. All right, any other anime jokes?
I'm pretty good. How about you?
Origins was good.
I never saw Origins. I'm sorry to
say. What?
I kept meaning to. I have it on my watch list. I'm going to watch it tomorrow. I'm going on a 6-hour car ride, so.
Oh, wow, that was surprisingly relevant. All right, quick decision. I saw the one of the new shorts that was revealed about the Hoopa thing, the Hoopa movie, and it was in a Middle Eastern country and all this stuff, and it was great, like traditional, stuff and all of that. I just wish they hadn't made donuts. I wish they had actually made some native bread, some local traditional breads. But okay, gotta Gotta appeal to the Japanese kids who don't know what the fuck's going on because they're so isolationist and totally not cultured in anything outside the region or America.
Now, we don't know that.
They have a
history.
Did you see the anime of their opinion of what they think Christianity is?
No, I didn't. Which anime are you talking about?
The anime with the kid whose dad is Satan. And there's a priest
who I know, Exorcist. Like, no, I didn't. But I did watch The Devil as a Part-Timer.
I watched some of that in the anime club because they put it on. And basically that's just the meme of Japan doesn't know. Japan thinks that the world actually has certain stuff in it that doesn't exist.
Well, I mean, that was a fantasy show.
I know, but they're so isolated that there are probably grown men who think that Catholic priests in America are fighting demons every day.
There's no one who thinks that. It was like a slice of life show, and it had like girls making guys bento, and it was like supposed to be set in American high school. Yes. Then I'd be worried, but I mean, we don't really fight demons, and I really don't think anyone thinks we do.
I regret saying everything I just said later, but oh well. Oh God, I accidentally. Okay, so yeah, that's watch the Hoopa thing. I don't. Are there two movies? Are there two movies? Here are the titles I've seen. Pokemon X and Y. Pokemon the 10th movie. Pokemon something something Hoopa something. I've seen Pokemon the strongest Mega Evolution. And I've seen Pokemon blah 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 someone fights the Kalos League. Like Kalem versus the Kalos League or something. And I've also seen Mega Evolution Part 4. What, is it two different movies? One doesn't have.
I don't know. It could be a movie and a short. They always come with shorts. So.
But we saw a 12-minute.
A lot of them seems like variations of a theme. So.
Well, the 4-part Mega Evolution series, does that have Ash in it?
I don't know. I'm keeping up with it.
Oh my God, it's so hard to follow. I just made a whole rant about effort, and we haven't put in any. All right. Goodbye, everybody.
All right. Good night. Or good morning.
You need to work on a sign out for SacredAsh.
We do.
You do.
I do. My channel. I can't have you do everything.
I do very little.
We all do very little at this stage. We need to get more organized.
I complain about editing when I could do it in 2 hours if I could fucking focus.
Same. Well, I can focus. I'm just a procrastinator. So, I'll get on that eventually.
Goodbye, everybody.